Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Skeeter Rabbit Connected Career Series here in Madden 16 on the Xbox One. Our two sport athlete taken to the field again, this time all the way across the pond in London. It's going to be the 3-4 Detroit Lions taking on the 4-3 Kansas City Chiefs, and they've gone a long, long way to get this one in. The NFL's experiment to play all these games here in London, so let's get it going here. Skeeter Rabbit trying to get teammates fired up right now, going down the line. Both teams have undoubtedly had to do a lot of press here playing overseas leading up to this one, but now it's time to simply play some football, some American football. And we will get this thing going with the Lions on offense first. Matthew Stafford apparently okay after last week's injury. As you see his numbers coming in there, I think that said 12 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. But he's got to stay healthy and stay on the field to give this team a chance to win. Trying to get outside here on the pitch. Obviously trying to use and utilize Skeeter Rabbit's speed first and foremost. Try to get him out wide there on those pitches and outside runs. Here on 2nd and 8, they're going to connect and almost get a first down. 3rd and inches means handing off to Skeeter Rabbit right up the middle, who gets the first down. And they'll move the chains here now. 1st and 10 from the 32. Again, trying the outside handoff, and he's got a pretty good run right there. He's going to pick up about 8 yards, I would say. Maybe they'll give him 9. Yeah, they give him 9 on the outside run right there. He is over 500 yards rushing on the season. However, he's had to have a lot of carries to do that. Here's that little misdirection play, hoping to hit that for a big play. He ran for a touchdown on that once this season. This time it's just a first down and a couple yards, but it's what they needed to get there the most. So he's taken down by a host of Kansas City Chiefs, but not before getting the first down. Now play action on 1st and 10, and Stafford will throw to Skeeter. Kind of the underneath decision right there, taking a little bit. He'll get 6 yards. The very next play, they're going to go ahead and try to pitch this out to the left-hand side. He's got a block, and he's got that first down, but hold up a second. There's a flag on the field. I'm afraid I know what this means. Looks like it's going to be holding against the Lions and come back, but let's see what the call is. That's exactly what it is. Holding on Golden Tate. So negate the first down there. Instead, it's 2nd and 8, and trying to set up a screen, and that works out all right. Skeeter's able to get that first down, spin around, get inside the 40, down to the 38-yard line of the Chiefs, and they continue this fairly lengthy drive starting off this first quarter as time continues to wind down in this first quarter, under 3 minutes. Now 2nd and 5. Gets positive yardage right there. He wants to avoid, obviously, going backwards. That's what seems to happen a lot. He gains a few yards, loses a few yards, and it seems to be such a battle. This time the fullback on 3rd and 2, not quite going to get it. It's going to be 4th and inches. They stay on the field with the offense, though, and this time Skeeter Rabbit will get it. He goes ahead and jukes a little bit and gets enough for the first down. So on 1st and 10, under a minute to play in the first quarter, and they are bottling up the pitch this time. He does lose a yard there, 2nd and 11. That turns into 3rd and 11, and Stafford throwing for the end zone, but it's going to be knocked away. They cannot connect right here. It'll be 4th down. And after that lengthy drive, they'll have to settle for a field goal attempt. The kick is up, and it is good. 3-0 Lions, the first score of the game, as we are just about through the first quarter. So now when we get the football back, we'll have to see what's happening here. The defense makes a stand. It's going to be time to punt. Well, that didn't take long either at the sideline, but Skeeter is able to field that and get a couple extra yards instead of that just going out of bounds. So that's where the Lions will pick up there at the 40-yard line. 3rd and 5. And the throw out to the flat, and that is Skeeter with the first down, securing the football before he gets hit quite hard and taken down, but he's got that first down and his 3rd reception of the game. Replay time? Yeah, let's look at it again. Stafford finds him in some open space, and instead of trying to make a fancy move there, he just makes sure he hangs onto the football because he remembers fumbling a couple times in that scenario. Here's a play that just does not work out for Stafford. He's lucky to get rid of the football, but it is 4th down. They're going to try a long field goal, 58-yarder to be exact, and it's wide left. Looked like he might have had the leg, but it is not accurate enough. We remain at 3-0. Kansas City goes down and gets a field goal of their own. We're now tied 3-3, 5 minutes left to play in the half. Trying to get this pass off. They can't even get the screen pass going. He's sacked before he can throw the football. 3rd and 18. They eventually punt, and they get it back here now, though. 2nd and 15 after another sack, and now he throws a pick. Stafford just all rattled here in the second quarter. and it's not going well. But hey, if they were sending a rush pretty much freely at you like that, you'd probably do the same thing. Stafford just not effective with heat in his face right there, and he throws that ball, yeah, not far enough, let's just say that. That was very poorly underthrown, but under pressure as well. So the Chiefs get the interception, and they're moving the other way. They'll take it down and get a field goal and take the lead before halftime. We got a minute 35 in which to work, and a kickoff coming here to Skeeter Rabbit if they'll let him field it. It's going to be short of the end zone, so he will take this back. We haven't seen a return here of anything very significant from him. As a matter of fact, this is probably one of his better ones out to the 34-yard line. But he is ranked 99 on kick returning. You think we'd have a little more explosiveness out there. Of course, you can kind of blame the user on that as well. Anyway, with just seconds left in the half, a big strike right there down to the 16. Got to hurry up as we have no timeouts. 10 seconds and counting. Stafford going to throw to the end zone, and he's got the touchdown. They're able to get it with just seconds left on the clock and get the score to put themselves ahead after all that. It's going to be 10-6 at halftime. That's Ebron making the catch, as we didn't really see it, obviously. Maybe we can catch it in the replay. Oh, yeah, one-on-one right there. He secures the football and gets in the end zone. So the Lions with the lead, and they'll get the ball to start the second half as well. So that's a nice little turnaround. Kick is caught right at the goal line, and Skeeter's coming out, switches the ball to his left hand. And again, one of his better returns, not saying a lot, but he's got a little bit of distance out to the 35-yard line, and that's where the Lions will start their second half. First possession, pitching out to the left side, and now, again, they're going to kind of bottle that up. They know exactly what the Lions are trying to do in their running game and utilize that speed, but maybe it's just going to be more effective out of the backfield today, catching passes. See, third and four coming up. Stafford's numbers were abbreviated last week because he got knocked out early again via injury. Going to be fourth down and four right here. And, yeah, Kansas City gets the punt. They go in and get their first touchdown of the day and take the lead 13-10. Midway through the third quarter, setting up a screen. And he's able to throw this one. Spin, stays on his feet, and gets some yardage. Well, he's going to be a couple yards short of the first down, but a nice job because he could have been dragged down immediately in the backfield. Instead, he turns that into third and two. What will they do on this third and two play? The fullback is in, but they're going to give it to Skeeter, and yeah, they're not fooled whatsoever. That play is stuffed, and like I said, you don't want your running back going backwards. He started quite positively in this game. I think it was like five carries for 20 yards, and ever since, he's kind of been going backwards. And once again, yeah, it's happening there too. The first down pitch, and he loses 3 yards. Definitely not the way he wants to go. Third and 12 now. Stafford, whoa, looking out, running for his life, throws this thing away. It's going to be fourth down and time to punt. Kansas City gets the football back and another touchdown. All of a sudden, they've got a 10-point lead as the third quarter is almost over. How about a draw play right here to Skeeter? Just trying to get him some space in which to run and create something. And it's an okay carry. You're going to have third and five now. Stafford again trying to set up a screen. Again, he does. And Skeeter gets just enough for a first down, as long as he gets the spot, which he does. First and 10 Lions, but they find themselves down 10 coming into the fourth quarter now. Crunch time, they got to get something going. Third and nine. That'll be a catch for Skeeter Rabbit. He's got first down yardage, hangs onto the football, and it'll be first and 10 at the 42 of the Lions. About 9 minutes to play in this game now. Down to 8 minutes. Time ticking away, and they need 10 points. So Stafford throwing again, and this will be a catch and a first down to the 40 of the Chiefs. Moving the football, but can they keep it going? Second and 10, keeping some heat off of Stafford, and it makes all the difference as, again, he's able to throw for a first down. Hey, if you keep him upright, things can be good, right? Third and three now, and this is over the middle for a first down. Get him down to the 13-yard line, first and 10. Moving this ball with about 6.5 to play. And the pass is to the end zone, or almost to it. It's caught at the one. They're down there. It'll be first and goal. Stafford over 200 yards passing now. And you bring the fullback in. Will this be a carry for Skeeter Rabbit? Yes, it is. A little spin move, and he's in untouched. Touchdown. A rushing touchdown for Skeeter Rabbit. Despite not having a whole lot of yardage in this game, he does get in for six. Watch the replay here as he just spins off the back of his fullback there and into the safety of the end zone. All right. Our little guy's gotten in there, got the score, but can the defense hold now that they're down just three? Let's find out. We go to the simulation, and then they do the opposite of that. They give up a touchdown, and it's back to a 10-point lead under 3 minutes to play. We're running out of time. 2:40 now. Stafford, again, has time to throw. He'll go underneath to Skeeter Rabbit. That's fine, but they got to move down the field a lot quicker than that. I guess Stafford didn't find what he liked down the field, as obviously they're being quite cautious on the defense. Second and two now, as you see Skeeter pick up a block up the middle, and that pass is complete down to the 33-yard line. They're not out of this yet. Right before the two-minute warning, Stafford to throw again. He rolls to the right, out of pressure. Finds Skeeter Rabbit for a first down. At least I think he's got it. Give him first and 10 at the 22-yard line at the two-minute warning. Skeeter needs a little bit of a breather right there, and he'll get it with the TV timeout at the two-minute warning. Second and three now. The throw is going to be caught. It's first and goal at the four. Hurry up to the line. Get this thing going. A minute 26 to play. Skeeter's open, and oh, they misfire right there. I might have just not run that route as crisply as I could have, and unfortunately we don't get the touchdown. Skeeter checks out of the game, and they do get another pass in the end zone to Ebron for a 4-yard touchdown reception, 27-24. It's sad to hear that we recovered the onside kick, but it must have been a penalty for not going too far, or not far enough, I mean, the 10 yards required, because then they just kneel down and this game is over. The Chiefs win it. Again, the Lions trying to make a comeback, and again it falls short. Stafford, 26 of 39 for 273 and two touchdowns, had the one interception, and just not enough in the end. They were trying to chase it there because of their defense. Not able to make all the stops they needed to in key points here. Skeeter Rabbit, 19 carries for just 24 yards. Like I said, he had 5 for 20, and then things kind of just went backwards as they figured him out. He does catch 9 receptions here for 78 yards, so that's where he stuck out in this game statistically. Anyway, after a bye in week 9, it is time for week 10 action against the Packers. Gonna go on the road, and they're 6-2. It's gonna be a tough task. Can the Lions get back on track? We'll see you next time for more Skeeter Rabbit. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com's a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.